As a visually impaired person and a mother of two visually impaired children, I can say that one can actually see from the time when I was at school, struggling to get a book, getting it late, while other children have received their books early, to my nine-year-old daughter who's in grade three, who's just started school, getting her books on time on the same day with other children. So South Africa has made a lot of progress. For us, given the current text, we are a bit ahead of the text because blind South Africans do read. We do have the library for the blind, but we also have the DAISY that ensures that blind people that can read books don't really have to buy very expensive books, but they're able to buy them in the format that they have. Access to works for visually impaired people in South Africa, a lot has been done already and a lot has been achieved. So we're hoping that this treaty will actually come to a point where the rules of engagement between publishers and authors can change, and so that authors can also become more sensitive, because it's not only about government, it's about the authors who need to also change the manner in which they make their works available, so that when publishers engage authors, that they engage them on different set of rules, so that the author should give consent up front, but also that the publishers need to begin to say, you need to ensure that we publish your books in the right format right from the beginning, so that no one has to ask back and forth and not have it. So we're hoping that this treaty will get us there. The message will be that they should not negotiate about blind people as helpless victims, but they should negotiate for blind people as equals and or as people that have rights, and that their rights must be affirmed, not as victims of charity in need of humanitarian, because they can also write, but they also can read. All that they need is for the book famine to end.